All right. So one of the things that's very helpful about regression is that in many ways it's very simple to visualize. It's very simple to think about what some of the issues are, and all the various topics in machine learning that are really important to understand and sometimes are difficult concepts really do come up in a fairly easy to understand way. So what I'd like to do now is to step through an example of doing some regression and to point out what some of the pitfalls are and how they're generally handled in the machine learning context. So this graph that I put up here is, we just made these numbers up, but it's supposed to tell us a little bit about housing prices. So let's imagine that we're off to buy a house, and what we notice is there's lots of different houses on the market, and there are lots of different sizes, right? So the square footage of the house can vary, in this case of the houses that I visited, between about 1,000 to 10,000 square feet. And of course, as you get bigger houses, you tend to get more, the prices tend to go up too, right? So the price that the house cost tends to rise with the size of the house. So what I've done here is I plotted as a little x, say, a set of 9 houses that I've observed. Start off over here with a house that's 1,000 square feet and it costs $1,000. I don't know what era this happened in. And we end up with a house that is 10,000 square feet and costs about $6,000. Again, this is not true in Providence, Rhode Island, I'll tell you that.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, it's certainly not true in Atlanta, Georgia.
So, all right, so imagine that this is the relationship that we observe, and now we want to answer a question like, well, what happens if we find a house on the market and it's about $5,000? What do you think a fair price for that would be? So what do you think, Charles, looking at this, what do you think a fair price for a 5,000 square foot house would be?
Apparently about $5,000.
About $5,000, right. So how did you do that?
I looked at the graph. I went over to 5,000 square feet on the x-axis, and I went up until I found where one of the x's was on the y-axis, and I said, oh, that's about 5,000 square feet.
Well, but there was no corresponding point for that, so you had to interpolate or something based on the points that were there. You had to kind of imagine what might be happening at the 5,000 square foot mark, right?
That's true, although this one was a little easy because at 4,000 and 6,000 square feet, they're almost exactly the same.
And so that's, to you, made it feel like there was probably, that's probably the level where things in this range would be.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. That seems kind of reasonable. So, sure. Though what we're going to do in this case is actually try to find a function that fits this.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So what we can do is actually say, well, what if there's a linear relationship? What would be the best linear function that captures the relationship between the size and the cost? So what I have here is, it turns out, of all the possible linear functions, this is the one that minimizes the squared error, the squared deviation between these x points and the corresponding position on the green line. So it finds a way of balancing all those different errors against each other, and that's the best line we've got. Now, in this particular case, it's interesting, right? Because if you put your idea of 5,000 square feet, look what this line predicts. It's something more like $4,000, right? Do you see that?
I do. That doesn't seem right to me.
It doesn't. Yeah, it doesn't really look like a very good fit. But it does at least capture the fact that there's increasing cost with increasing size.
That's true.